Hello and welcome viewers back to another video where today we are going to be working on this 400 watt HID, specifically metal halide and mercury vapor floodlight. And so far I have taken the insides out and replaced the socket as well because now we need to paint it. Okay viewers, I've got the front plate all sanded here and I'm going to paint it with some spray paint. Alrighty viewers, our replacement socket is now mounted to its little bracket here, like that. And then the old socket, I don't know how you manage, but it was totally broken. So now I'm going to sand and remove all the parts from this outer enclosure, and then I'll paint that. Okay viewers, so I've got the inside and outside of that big guy sanded, and you can see the paint I'm using is a little darker, but I think it's really an improvement overall, so I'm going to stick with it. Alright viewers, I have the new painted frame with the clean window glass installed with these little clips. I did not do more windshield sealant because it's not going to be outside, and the old stuff was actually still in pretty good shape, so I just kind of squished it back down again. Hopefully that'll do all right. Okay viewers, while we're waiting on that to dry, we're gonna work on the wiring part of it. Now this cap, the Aerovox 24 microfarad, matches the sticker on the ballast and tests at 25 microfarad, so I'm actually pretty happy with that. Now these wires down here, I don't know if you can see it, but they are severely crispy. I mean, it is really bad. I mean, you can just hear them crunching. So what I'm gonna do is slice them down as close to the ballast as we can get with still having some room left. And also, there's a whole bunch of different voltage taps here, so we don't really need all these wires. So I'm gonna slice them back and replace them with some modern wire so that it's a little safer. Alright viewers, so I've completed most of our wiring here, and you can see these are your other voltages, so I just sliced them down. This is our cap line, and then that goes to the hot of the lamp, and then the hot of the lamp goes to the neutral, which also is going to go to the power cable's neutral. There were two common lines coming out of the transformer, so I just hooked them together here. And of course, here's the hot to the power cord. So now let's go put it in the case and install a power cord. Okay viewers, welcome back. So I have wired it up here correctly, and I have tested it, and it worked just fine. As you can see, so the ballast is strapped in there. This capacitor strap, I have doubts that that's the original, but it seems to work fine, so I'm gonna leave it. The problem I'm facing now is that my lamp holder, it doesn't do its thing. So the way this works is your reflector here, there's a hole in the side, right? Well, this guy needs to screw into those two holes in the top of the reflector. And you can see there's actually like three of them on there, but it's the wrong way around. So I'm gonna put that in the vise and bend it the other way. I have absolutely no idea how they did that originally, but it wasn't very good because that means it wasn't screwed in. So also the clearance is really tight and you kind of need it to be like that to fit your big honker in there. That's a black light. Okay, so I'm gonna put it in the vise and bend it. Okay guys, so I got all the way to this point. Turns out that 90 is unbendable. I don't know, it has these little supports. So I did that big loop-de-doo, it took me like 10 minutes. And it occurred to me, I just had the lamp holder on backwards. So I gotta reverse this damage. Okay viewers, here is our finished product, at least for now, with a black light blue 400 watt lamp in there. That thing is too big for this fixture. It's the correct wattage and I think the correct like kind of bulb, but it doesn't really fit in the reflector. If they had made it just an inch bigger on all sides, it would have fit perfectly. So I'm not entirely sure what's going on there, but it's in there, and it's on, and it's not that loud. Paint job, I think I'm pretty happy with. You can see the sides. It's just dirt. So I'm going to let that run a little while. Make sure it doesn't catch on fire, but other than that, I think I'm going to call this a success. Thank you, and goodbye for now.